Hi, I'm Jamin.
And I'm Amanda. Today we're going to show you how to add checklists to your Gantt chart.
Sometimes you may want a little more detail on a task than what's in the timeline.
Maybe you want to show the steps involved to complete a task.
My dad used to handle that with his trusty old notepad.
But we don't need that, because TeamGantt makes it easy with a built-in checklist feature.
He also used it to take notes on what he really thought about people.
What do you say we show them how it works?
Mm-hmm.
Start by mousing over the left column for the task you want to add a checklist to.
You'll see an icon for the checklist appear.
Click on the icon and the checklist will open. By default, it includes one item.
If you rename the item, it will add it to the checklist. If you hit enter, another item is added below.
You can add as many items as you like, and when you're finished, just click outside the checklist window and you'll see that the number of checklist items is displayed next to the checklist icon.
You'll also see a zero listed to the left of the number of checklist items. That number shows how many items have been completed. If you click on the checklist icon, you can check off any items that have been completed. Now, when you click off the checklist window, you'll see the number of completed items has been updated.
And that's it. Checklists are a fun and easy way to keep track of those little details associated with your tasks. Just click on the list, add an item, check it when it's complete, and we're done. Right, Jamin?
And finish showing how to use checklists in TeamGantt. Check. Now we're done.